Hello and welcome to the show. I am here on the crew with some more vehicles driving up the Pikes Peak hill climb course, and we start today with a Chevrolet Impala with what looks like Wally sticking out of the engine. It's an interesting engine thing we've got going on there. As far as ridiculous wings go, we kind of got a table on the back of our Chevy. We've got some big old side exit exhaust, and we've got an incredibly chrome front splitter, and the spoiler itself is pretty shiny as well. Yeah, some interesting modifications on this Impala. It is a performance spec vehicle, and as ever with this series, it is a basic level 40 car. We're going to have a look at the, not that one, this is the one we want, the car tuner. We have got quite a lot of torque, almost 800 torque in this car, which is one of the highest amounts we've seen, other than perhaps the big trucks, getting nearly 700 horsepower, and it doesn't weigh that much, 3,400 pounds, which for cars on the crew is not too bad, actually, considering this vehicle's size and everything. It's not too bad on the weight front. I also think that we may not struggle too much with the front splitter. We've seen a few cars scraping their way up the course. I think this one here is high enough, you know. I think that's not going to be a problem. Concerns for this car, well, it could be quite oversteery. It is a classic American vehicle. There are potential for oversteery problems. Tires do look nice and wide at the back. Look pretty damn huge. Yeah, it could be a surprise package. It could go quite like the BMW M5. It could be a nice surprise, this, or it could be very difficult to drive. I'm not sure which, but we are going to find out. If I can remember the buttons for this game, I haven't played it for a while. As ever, there will be no nitro used on this run. It's going to be the pure car's performance. That's not handbrake, for God's sake. It's been a little while, okay? I have to run up this hill a couple of times just to make sure I do remember the course. Right, okay, that's what handbrake is. And we are underway with the Impala. Yeah, we didn't even scrape the front of the car on that initial launch. I think we're pretty much safe with running up here. The silly the Wally engine thing is a little bit in the way, and then there is some big oversteer moments. Okay, it's kind of so far how I expected it to drive. It's not got the greatest steering in the world, and it is quite oversteer. In fact, this is, again, for a car on the crew, this does feel very oversteering. Often the cars, especially when you put them up to this sort of spec and give them this level of parts, they tend to be quite nice to drive. This is not at all. This is a very, very oversteery car, and it feels quite heavy as well. Kind of feels like the Hummer did, a little bit slow to respond to any inputs. Get around that corner, and there's a very big slide. That's not going to help the time much. Come on, car, we'll get... It's quite fun to drive, I will give it that. It is quite an entertaining drive. Whoop, there's a Ferrari going the other way. That has nearly ended badly. Come on then, I think about trying to leave it in a higher gear. Can't quite get away with that. There we go. Chuck it in. You see, with the Focus, you could throw it into the corners and it would grip, and you could fire it out of the other side, and it was absolutely lovely to drive. With this, you can chuck it into the corners, go very sideways, and then lose a whole stack of time. Slightly bounced it off a wall there. Yeah, we are struggling with putting the power down out of these corners. It isn't struggling so much over the bumps, which does surprise me. When it's got this much sort of wheel spin out of the hairpins, I would expect it to be, you know, wheel spinning its way over some of the bumps. But it's not doing that, which is kind of reassuring to an extent. Wee. No, we have not got the grip. We have got a lot of speed in this car, though. This is pretty damn... I mean, this is sort of circuit car speed down here, 160 miles an hour. Over the jump, and we are okay. On the landing, it doesn't get all unhappy with me. Play it dangerous with the rocks there. That's never a good line to be taking through there. But we did get away with it, and then wait for there to be traffic. Oh, we're all out of shape in this corner. It's not... Oh, there's no traffic either. It's just not the... Whoa! God dear, that was a scary moment. We're running a bit wide. It's across the line for the Impala. It's just a bit dodgy to drive. this car, it does not have a lot of grip. It is quite oversteery, and the steering does not feel, it's just, yeah, it drives how you expect an old Impala to drive, or how I would expect an old Impala to drive. It's oversteery and it's not got the greatest sort of cornering grip. You can get it up the course with only a couple of dings on the wall. It's not an easy car to drive though. It's not the nicest I've had up this course, and not quite as scary as I thought it could possibly end up. It does have a bit of grip. It doesn't have problems with the bumps, but yeah, coming out of the tighter hairpins, you do get quite a lot of wheel spin and spend quite a bit of time sideways in this car. Up next, we have got the Mercedes-Benz SL63 AMG. This time, in circuit spec, it's essentially a DTM car. That's what the what this kit looks like. It's got all the very crazy DTM aero parts. We've got a fairly sizable rear wing and, well, rear everything with the aero parts. Yeah, it's a circuit car. We're expecting it to be pretty quick. The problems are, well, the front is very low to the ground. On this car, yeah, that is some very low ride height, as you would imagine from a fully fledged race car, but on this very bumpy circuit that can cause problems. Sometimes we got away with it. The Dodge Challenger got away with it last time without really scraping the floor, so we may be lucky with this car, or it could potentially cause problems. The other downside with these circuit cars is wheel spin can be an issue over some of the bumps for a few of them. Not all the circuit cars have problems. I don't know what this one is like. I have never driven this car before. So, yeah, who knows what we're going to get from it. Again, standard level 40 stuff in this vehicle, 709 horsepower, 647 torques. So a little bit more powerful, slightly less torque though than the Impala. It is a little bit heavier, despite being a stripped out racing car. It's a little heavier than the Impala. I'm not quite sure how that one works, but it is. I'm hoping though that we will have a bit more grip in this car. I'm hoping we will have more cornering grip, that yeah, we can carry more speed through these corners, and we're not going to waste as much time sliding. Having said that, we could end up scraping the front bumper the whole way up the course, and that could be a problem. Who knows? Or we could have terrible oversteer every time we hit a small bump. That is also a potential problem. Right, we shall set off with the Mercedes. Oh, we didn't scrape the front of the car on the floor. That's a good sign. That's a reassuring sign. I don't quite know how we got away with that, but just be glad that we did. Ooh, okay. That's not normal. The front of the car does not normally want to go up in the air there. That's a small concern. Okay, can we not do that? Oh, hello, Mr. Policeman Officer over there. Don't mind me. Don't mind me at all. I'm not doing 100 and something miles an hour. It's fine. Okay. I'm... Whoa! Now, this has got some interesting, scary bits to it. Okay, so we're not actually scraping the front of the car. Why is it doing that? Okay, I cannot quite fathom out why it is that this car is bouncing up into the air. The front of the vehicle is not... No, keep it on the track. Keep, bloody hell. The front of the vehicle isn't so much scraping the floor, but something is very unhappy with this course, and I can't quite figure out when we go over these bumps. Ooh, it's just, the car is just slightly lifting up into the air, sometimes more noticeable than others. The handling is not happy with these bumps. It does not like... It does not like this particularly nasty, or this... fairly nasty surface. While yes, it is all tarmac up here, it's not the smoothest of tarmacs, and it will chuck cars around, and this one here is being quite badly affected by this. Right, we can be neat through there. I mean, we've got no wheel spin, no traction problems from this car at all, which is nice in a circuit car, and we can carry good speed through that corner. Just got to be careful that I don't clip any small bumps that will throw this car around. We've got decent acceleration. Again, as you would expect from a circuit car, you know, these things are going to be fast around the corners, on the acceleration and so on. It should have good straight line speed down this next bit, which it does have. Yeah, it's pretty damn quick. We're past 160 miles an hour. Ooh, okay, a little bit of airtime over there. We didn't get flung up on the landing though, which is lovely. Then we can be neat through these next couple of corners. It's not going to do it again, now I talked about that weird behaviour over some of the bumps. Ooh, Big up truck in the middle of the corner. That's not ideal. Yeah, it's going to behave itself now. A couple of times it got a little bit scary, and it did take a slight bump off a mound, I think on the side of the course, that it got airborne from. Otherwise, not a bad car. Won't like the rough stuff, though. It will not like any slightly bumpy road. This vehicle, you're going to have to keep it on the very smooth circuit, otherwise you're going to get unhappy. I can't figure out quite what it is. Maybe it is to do with the very low ride height. I don't know, it's over the heavy bumps, it did the front especially wanted to just lift up a bit, which is a scary thing to have a car be doing. But it did make it to the top of the course with only one minor issue. Elsewhere, yeah, it's a nice circuit car to drive, has excellent grip, can carry a hell of a lot of corner speed if you get things right. So, yeah, overall, not too bad of a car, just got to be a little bit careful. And our third and final vehicle today, it is the Ford Shelby GT500. I am expecting more oversteer to end this particular episode. We have got a big wing, fairly silly wing, on the back. I like how it's sort of cut into the boot. Strange, interesting wing on the back of this car. We've got front aero-y bits, we've got rear aero-y bits. I don't think we've got, they might be a similar sized tire actually to the Impala on the rear there. Oh, we've got the engine sticking out the bonnet, of course. We haven't quite got Wally on the engine this time, which is slightly disappointing. I want that on every car now. But yeah, it's a Mustang. It's got a lot of power. In fact, how much power do we have? There's the mobile car tuner thing go. 690 horsepower, almost as much torque. And the heaviest car of the lot, but not by much. It's only, what, 100 pounds heavier than the Mercedes? Maybe not even that? That Merc is really quite a heavy vehicle. Surprises me. I didn't think the Mercedes was going to be a stripped out race car. Didn't think it was going to be that heavy. But yeah, the oversteer is going to be the problem with this car. It's got plenty of power. It'll be a quick car. It's whether we can use that power without it trying to throw us off the course. That is what I'm nervous about, and that is what you would expect from a GT500. But you never know. Maybe the Ford will be a surprise. Maybe it'll turn out to be an absolutely lovely vehicle. Who knows? We will find out. I'm somehow not expecting that one. We may well end up in a wall somewhere. Let's find out, though, as we set off on the hill climb route. The front splitter is not going to be a problem then. If we're not scraping on the initial launch, then I think we have enough ride height, which is always useful. And through these first corners, what do we... Okay, there's a bit of a... We have a bit of a moment through the second corner. I was initially thinking there was a bit of grip through there. I may have pushed it just a little bit too hard. Okay, we've got a bit of traffic coming up through here, as per usual. And there we go, that's more like it. Okay, the Shelby does have a lot more grip than I expected. I may have got a little bit brave through the after turning into the initial corner and finding grip. No, he's not got as much grip as some cars that I've driven up here. Doesn't have as much grip as the Mercedes, as you'd expect. That's a bloody circuit car. But this is not the slidey oversteer fest that we expected from a GT500. Look at that. Whee, okay. Almost look at that. Not quite. Ignore the final bit. But yeah, I mean, I'm being really super aggressive with the throttle on this car. I'm treating it basically like a circuit vehicle up here. And it has enough grip to almost get away with that. It will oversteer when pushed very hard, as you would expect. But unlike the Impala that was spinning its wheels up and sliding out of every corner given the opportunity, this thing will only do it when you're being an absolute moron. See, around there, that plane is looking like it's going at an interesting angle. Around that corner, it's absolutely fine. There are no problems. If I'm sensible with the car, provided I'm not driving it like a moron, you can get a lot of corner speed out of this Shelby. That is really quite good through the corners, and not what I expected. I think I may have had a bit of a lockup coming into this corner. Again, second gear into third gear, all flat out, and there's no problems for the Ford. That's not what I expected from this car at all. I thought we'd be sliding more than, or as much at least, as the Impala, but no, the Shelby is absolutely fine across the jump. Not quite as quick as the Mercedes. Again, I'm not really surprised. Merc was a circuit car. This is only in a performance spec. Wouldn't expect it to perhaps be as quick, but it's not that far off. We have again got a couple of cars on the inside of that particular corner. One more corner to go. It's sort of easily flat out through here. Oh, we've got a little bit of a scrape as he came through the dip there across the line for the Shelby. That's not at all what I expected from this car. No. I was really thinking we were going to be slipping and sliding our whole way up the course there. But the GT500 is really not a bad car to drive. It will still oversteer when pushed hard. It will still slide around if you are a bit of a mort. But you have to be a real throw the car around every corner, sort of in a driving mood, if you want this to slide. Because if you're a little bit careful with the throttle, you're not going to have any problems at all. A lot more grip from this than expected. Which, yeah, it's nice. It's a nice car to drive. Maybe not quite as nice as the M5 or the Focus, but still a pretty good and a pretty big surprise from the Shelby here. So on to the times, and it is the Shelby GT500 that sets the most impressive time of the day, possibly the biggest surprise of this entire series, with a 2:28.0, and I am pretty sure that car would have gone second had I not got a big slide in the early part of that course. There's only 0.2 of a second behind the Silverado. That GT500 is seriously quick. It is a bit oversteery. It is a little bit more difficult to drive than some of the other vehicles, but he's blooming fast to set that time. The Mercedes is down in 10th with a 2:29.5. And that's more down to my driving than the car. I'm pretty sure that would have been right up there as well had I not got things a tiny bit wrong when I bounced off a rock or some form of scenery. Just the landing of the jumps throws the Mercedes a little bit. If you get things right though, I have no doubt that'll be a very quick car, a decent time from the Merc. And we have to go further down as expected to find the Impala's time, a 2:32.1. It just wastes too much time being sideways, as you would expect. With the way that that car drove, it does go quicker than the Shelby GT500, and the poor Ferrari 458 that scraped its way up the hill is still right down towards the bottom. Anyway, that is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, a goodbye.